Flattening seismic data to horizons is a useful technique for aiding interpretation and understanding depositional history. The flattener process creates an isoproportional view of your data based on horizons. The resultant flattened space is accessible in any of the views, using the same simple approach that InSight uses to view in time or depth. Let's take a look at the flattener now. To create this perspective, we'll need a flattener process. Open the Process tab and click the Add button in the top right-hand corner. There are a lot of processes here. We can quickly find the flattener by typing flat in the search box. Give the new process a name and click OK. These two buttons allow different approaches to configuring the flattener. The first button adds individual horizons, allowing you to specify and configure them one at a time. This is useful when you want more control over which active horizons to use. The second button automatically creates a structure using all the visible horizons. We'll use that now. InSight sorts the horizons based on average times or depths, and calculates the flat value for us. Remember that in flattened space, each horizon has a single time or depth. This is the flat value. InSight calculates this value by averaging the maximum and minimum for the horizon. You can update this value manually if you prefer. We can take advantage of the flattened projection in any of the InSight views. The domain selector contains two-way time, true vertical depth, and also the new flattened perspective. Change from two-way time to the flattened domain. Notice that the horizons selected in the flattener are all perfectly flat. The default behavior is to proportionally stretch and squeeze the data to completely fill each interval, but it is easy to change this. As with most processes in InSight, these parameters are interactive. If we change the conformability settings here, the display is updated on the fly. This stratigraphy might be conformable to the top or base of the mid-horizon. This is very useful for reconstructing a depositional environment. Horizons can be picked and propagated in the flattened domain. Note that if the picked horizon is part of the flattener process, the projection will not be updated until after leaving editing mode. We can find another useful feature of the flattened projection in the map view. Let's move the navigation bar to show a time slice through our depositional environment, around slice 1141 milliseconds, and then open the map view. By enabling the slice in the flattened domain, we see an amplitude extraction of proportional spacing between the flattened horizons. We can then see different extracted slices by scrolling up and down through the flattened volume. This is much more powerful than simply viewing amplitude extractions along specific horizons.
If you have questions or would like to discover more, then visit our website at www.dog.com. And remember, have fun with InSight!